There we go.
Yeah, good.
Lorenzo, what's happening, bro?
Hey, man, I love what y'all doing, bro. This is major right here, bro. I love what y'all doing, bro.
Hey, appreciate that, bro, man. Yeah, man, we wanted to provide a platform. We used to host talent shows back in high school, man. I'm an artist, so I get it, man. You want a place where you can shine and showcase your talent, man. The pandemic happened. I was like, man, what's something that we can do to let people get their talent and get their shine on, man? I'm one of the few artists that actually enjoy seeing other people shine. It's rare.
I host at the comedy club that's here in Augusta, the Joker's Comedy Club. I'm the host, so I provide the same opportunities that y'all do, bro. Same thing. Music, comedy, anything. Same thing.
Fire, bro. Fire, bro. So what made you put that wig on tonight? Where was the...
Oh, bro, this is one of my characters that I use on stage, bro. Nunchuck Williams.
Okay. Hey. I feel like we got to get out of your way, bro. So just the screen is yours. Do you?
Hey, so you said we can get down, right? We get down.
Get
okay,
out.
Well, I'm gonna tell you like this, bro. We finna make history because I got the cure for the coronavirus, bro. Everybody going to get the vaccine. I got the cure for it, bro. You can take it. You can do it through nose or through your mouth, bro.
Go for it.
You ready?
We ready? If he pull his dick out, though, I'm gonna.
Y'all ready? Let's get out.
Oh, shit.
Look here, bro. When the election hit, bro, when Trump lost, bro, I was filming a movie in Atlanta, bro. I was filming a movie. But I fucked around and went to Walmart, bro. Everybody was tripping. All the white people was tripping like a motherfucker. And I walked by this white lady, bro. She was looking at me mean than a motherfucker. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong? And I didn't say nothing to her. But as soon as she walked by, she was like, what did you say? What did you say? I was like, damn, I ain't said shit to you. You're all going to bow down one day. It's the Capitol. I believe she was trying to tell me something. She said, it's the Capitol. So we went through, got grocery shopping. Then we got to the register. Guess who was in front of me? She was. She rang it up. She got 3 buggy loads full of shit and didn't have enough money to pay for her fucking groceries. But I told her, I was like, look here. You see how mean you was to me back there? I was raised right. I was raised in the church, as you can see. I was raised in the church. I helped the lady. The God in me made me help her. I helped that bitch put all them groceries back. Me and my children. I turned the DMX on that hoe. Get the fucking Haroldus, Pete. Put them back. Get them. No matter of fact, give them to me so I can put them in my head. And I'm like, I don't understand what the fuck they what made Trump, what has he done to make them support them this much? You know what I'm saying? And Facebook, they be hating like a motherfucker. They told me to take my post down on my coronavirus, healing on my coronavirus. But I said, you're going to let Trump stay up. This bitch got up and did an interview like this.
Well, I want to let the world to know that I want you to get rid of the coronavirus. You just inject some bleach and drink a little bit of Lysol and you'll live longer.
I was like, so this is what the fuck the people is following? This motherfucker? And when COVID hit, man, it fucked up a lot of things. Shout out to all the 2020 graduates, man, that couldn't walk across the stage, bro. Yeah. Shout out to all the 2020 graduates. Because I couldn't walk across the stage when it was time for me to graduate either.
Yeah.
Because I quit school. You know what I'm saying? So I didn't walk. I quit. You know what I'm saying? Because when I got to the high school, bro, shit was different for me, bro. Like, school was kind of fast, and I wasn't no fast learner. I told the truth, I was kind of slow. But they didn't, you know, the class I was in, I got in one day, you know what I'm saying, signed up a class. Waiting on all my class members coming in. 4 fucking members showed up. On the 400 hall, bro. They had me in special ed. And it was me, 2 other students, and then a girl in a wheelchair. And I had a crush on this bitch. But I didn't know her boyfriend was Kendall. He was real retarded and real strong, and he used to push her wheelchair. And it's, so I'm giving her game one day, right? Trying to take her to the bathroom. Now, mind you, in this classroom, I'm going on 20-some years old, nigga. I'm old enough to cuss. The teacher can't tell me I can't goddamn cuss. I raise my hand. I got to go to the bathroom. This bitch make the whole class line up. We all got to go to the bathroom. I said, oh, hell no. I can't take no much more of this shit. And then, bro, we had a fire drill, bro. My mama coming to the school looking for me. My sister looking for me. My class is out there letting go balloons. We out there, bitch, letting go balloons doing a fire drill, bro. I said, no, I can't do that. And then my fucking teacher, bro, she embarrassed me, bro. She told me to pass my class, all I had to do was draw a map from my classroom to the principal's office. The principal's office is 3 doors down the goddamn hallway. And I said, look here, fuck this. While I'm here, I might as well make the best of it. So I started talking to an old girl in a wheelchair. Like I told you, I didn't know that was Kendall's old lady. This nigga got mad. He went to talking all that bullshit and speaking all that retarded language. I didn't understand it. But I'm like, hey, bro, it ain't even like that, bro. I'm trying to help her. I'll take her little wheelchair to Jiffy Lube and get a little oil change or whatnot. He was like, so he talking that shit. This nigga got butt-ass naked. You want to fight? You want to smoke? Then he started talking clear. I'm like, this bitch is not retarded. He is not fucking retarded. So I was like, look, I can't, and I had to go ahead and quit school behind that. That's why I didn't walk. That's my story, and I'm fucking sticking to it. That's why I didn't fucking walk. You know what I'm saying? Because I said, every day, I had to run out the class. When the bell rang, nigga, I had to run out the classroom so my sisters and my cousins and them didn't know I was in special ed. I had to run out that motherfucker. And we were sitting in the lunchroom, bro. My class would go to lunchroom. My fucking lunchroom is huge. Man, they would sit us one student over here across here, one student way the fuck back there, the other student way over there, and then my sister would come in the lunchroom. They'd be laughing like a motherfucker. I'm like, bitch, I'm helping the teacher. I'm not in this class. This nigga slobbing and shit, can't control himself. His eye won't stay open. This is some strange motherfucker. I got to get out of here. They irk me. They really irk me. But like I was saying, man, shit was strange, bro. You have to believe in yourself, man. We done made it to 2021, bro. We lost a lot of people in 2020. 2020 was fucked up for a lot of people, bro. But we're here. We made it through. Like, we lost Chadwick Boseman, bro. Give it up for him. We lost him. Because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have my son right now, bro. If it wasn't for Chadwick Boseman, I wouldn't have my son. Me and my wife used to role play, and I used to be Black Panther. Mm. Fucking, you know what I'm saying? Turn over this way. A man has a right to protect his family. You're going to take this dick, and I'm going to flip you over. You're going to suck this dick. And I was aiming left, and I got my wife pregnant, and I've been able to have a son. But you have to be careful what you let these kids listen to while they're in your wife's stomach. Because my wife used to watch TV and watch reality shows and shit. And then when my son was born, bro, you know, I used to let him listen to Michael Jackson. He loved Michael Jackson right now. But when he was born, bro, I would change his diaper. He would never, like, piss or shit in his diaper. He would wait until I owned the diaper. And he would piss all over my face, bro. I'm like, what the fuck? So I thought about it, and I snapped. I said, I told you not to be watching that bullshit on TV. She was sitting there watching Surviving R. Kelly. Got my son pissing all over me, bro.
Hey, I'ma stop you there. Hey, bruh, funny stuff, bruh. Funny. Hey, let me ask you a question.
What's up?
Is that real cocaine that you have on your nose?
Hey, mind your goddamn business.
Okay, shout out to that.
No, I'm just playing, man. That's cake mix. I do not do cocaine, bro. All this shit is happening.
Hey, I mean, you done said about three or four things to get you canceled already. So I thought, hey, you're just going all the way forward.
Just go forward.
This is what I admire about you, bro. Because, like I said, I'm a comedian. And yeah. There'll be people that'll be offended by some of the stuff you said. Using the R word, for instance, right?
Republican?
Yeah. Where you from? Where you from?
I'm from Keyville, Georgia, bro. Small town. If you blank your eyes, you do that motherfucker.
Hey, so this is what I respect about you, bro. The fact that you hungry in the game. You like, yo, I'm finna be funny, period. You know what I'm saying? I'm finna say exactly because it's all jokes. I get it as a comedian, bro. So I just wanted to tell you to keep doing your thing, bro. Keep doing you. Be authentic. That I'm telling you, people will try to tell you to change and all. Man, do you.
I mean,
do you, bro, because you being you is, at the end of the day, what's funny. That's my personal thoughts. What y'all got to say?
Yo, man, yeah, you was funny as hell, man. I definitely was like, oh, he's going to get canceled. But you know, I can respect, you know, I was watching Eddie Murphy Raw the other day, and he was making some joke about not letting gay people see his butt, so he turned around real quick on stage. I was like, damn, he wouldn't be able to tell that joke right now today. But, you know, at the same time, like, freedom of speech is all jokes, man. Don't come here trying to catch these jokes. So do you, man, do you.
How long you been doing stand-up?
Bruh, this July be 3 years, bruh.
Gotcha. My bad, Ulysses, you about to say something?
Nah, hey, man, I'm about to say, man, keep your foot on their necks. That's
always.
It. Nunchuck, Larry, bro. Keep your foot on their neck, all right? I was waiting for some nunchucks to come out, actually.
Where my damn nunchucks?
Where they at? He got the nunchucks. Hey, if y'all want to tip Lorenzo while he get them nunchucks, his Cash App is WMT210. WMT210. Lorenzo Williams is his Cash App. What's your social media?
Hey, it's comedian Lorenzo Williams on everything, bro. I want to give a shout out too, man. This Duranis Pace, man. She just passed away, man. I got on this and I filmed with her, bro. I'm in a TV series with her. She was on Steve Harvey show and she made him cry. She passed away, bro. It was so, and I got a chance to film with her, bro. And she talked to me and I helped her get in the van and she sung to me, bro. It was so powerful, bro. She was telling me about the power of the Lord, bro. It was so powerful. I mean, I shed a tear and whatnot. It was tough, man. But rest in peace to her, man. She was such a sweetheart. She was so sweet, bro.
Absolutely, bro. Absolutely, man. Well, rest in peace to her. Prayers go out to her family. Thank you, bro, for doing this, man. Keep doing your thing, man. And you already know this, I'm sure. Comedy, I've been doing stand-up for 13 years now. It's definitely a marathon. But the more you do it, you just go only get better and better. You already funny, you know, but the more you do it, the more seasoned you go get, the more comfortable you go feel. You already seem comfortable in your own skin already, but just keep doing it. That's all I'm saying. Keep doing the videos on social media. Keep building that fan base, bro. And yeah, man, keep doing your thing, bro. This is just the beginning for you.
Hey, y'all gonna look for me, man. I'm finna film my ninth movie, bro. Being on stage and led the stage plays, and now I'm filming movies, bro. Like Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Well, I can't really say too much, but this is my ninth movie. I start back filming on the 25th, bro. In 3 years, if you're doing what God put you on this earth to do, watch out. Everything else get out of your way and it happen for you.
Straight up. Amen. Lorenzo Williams, man. Hey, Cash App, WMT210, if you want to tip him, man. Thank you, brother. Keep doing your thing, man.
Hey, man, y'all boys, suck it easy and swallow slow, him.
What? The hell? What the hell you talking about?
I don't feel safe on this platform anymore.
What did that say? Sucking and swallowing. You the only one sucking and swallowing, sir. And Lee. Lee sucks and swallows.
You know what? We keeping this PG-13.
Hey, man. All right, man. We coming to the tail end of this thing, man.